Good afternoon. Welcome back to another edition of the BNH Virtual Event Space. You are tuned into Creating Content with AI-powered 360 cameras, sponsored, of course, by Insta360. And to go over this wonderful technology, we have Mr. Adam Stringer join us from Insta360. Adam, what's going on, man?
Absolutely fantastic to be here, Derek. Really excited to be hosting the webinar today and talking to you guys through our brand new camera, the X3, and all the incredible things it can do.
That's awesome. We were talking earlier, Adam. You know, Adam was showing me the presentation, give me a little preview, and I'm like, my mind is blown by the things that cameras are able to do now. And some of the stuff that you guys are doing over there, it doesn't make sense to me. It's so cool. For anybody who's not familiar with what 360 cameras are doing now, it's mind blowing. So I'm going to get out of the way because I'm just as excited to be a viewer for this as I am to host this. So Adam, I'm going to let you take over. As always, if you guys do have any questions, feel free to get them in. Adam's going to get those answered for you after we wrap up the presentation today, but show's all yours, Adam.
Brilliant. Thanks so much, Derek. And let's kick on with the webinar. Right. Let me just get my screen shared here, guys. Fantastic. Okay. So here we are. Welcome again to the Insta360 webinar today with BNH, creating content with AI-powered 360 cameras. And guys, I've got a lot of exciting things to be talking through with you today. So let's jump right in. So a quick introduction to myself here. My name's Adam. I'm a senior marketing specialist at Insta360. I'm based in Berlin, Germany, and I support marketing strategy and partnerships across Europe and North America. So I've been pulled in today and have the honor to host this webinar. So super exciting. Right. So agenda for today, what we're going to be doing. So first, who are Insta360? Who is Insta360? As Derek mentioned, a very interesting company. We're churning out a lot of things and making some big waves in the industry. So I'll give you a rundown on that. And then an intro to Insta360 X3. So our brand new camera that literally just launched last Thursday. Next, we'll go over some cinematic shots without the equipment. How do we create these incredible shots with a pocket-sized action camera? Impossible shots with a 360 camera. We'll follow along with that. And then lastly, preview of the Insta360 app interface so you guys can see how we make these incredible shots all on our app. Okay, so let's jump right in. Who are we? Who are Insta360? Okay, so just sliding my picture screen across there. So our mission is to help people better capture and share their lives. Our vision to become one of the world's top camera brands through bold innovation. And along with this mission, we're almost there. So we're currently the number one 360 camera company in the world on market share, 35% there. We're also just over 7 years old, but it's worth mentioning. So we started in 2015 and already we're sold in more than 200 countries and regions globally. And as you can see too, there's some more awards on the screen there, the world's most innovative companies. We were 2020 honoree there from Fast Company, which was a huge achievement. And think bold. So our slogan, our philosophy of our whole company, think bold. So Insta360, we champion the boldest, craziest, wildest of ideas, and put them into action. So you'll see later on in the webinar, I'm going to be showing you guys a ton of incredible content from our creators, our athletes across a multitude of sports, all encapsulating this all in covering slogan, think bold. And when people say that's impossible, we say, let's do it. So from a cliff dive to a cinematic production, we really help everyone capture the magic in every moment with our cameras. And you can see two of our athletes here, Hunter Cowald on the left, a sky surfer, hoverboard inventor, like the Green Goblin from Spider-Man that we all call him. Absolutely incredible guy. And then Evan Lalane on the right. I've had the pleasure of meeting Evan. He's paralyzed, but he rips downhill super fast on e-boards and does tons more incredible things. Okay, and sorry, just to jump back as well there to mention, a bit more about the company. So we have started in 2015 and we're now over 900 employees. And we have our headquarter office, you might see on the map there in Shenzhen in China. And then we have satellite offices in Tokyo, Los Angeles, Berlin, and Hong Kong. And I'm currently located in Berlin. Sorry to jump back on you guys there. Okay, so we're creating the future of the camera. So as you can see here, a wide variety of action cameras and also professional and prosumer cameras to the right. And actually today, so just in the last month, we also released Insta360 Link, which is an AI powered 4K webcam. And that's what I'm using to shoot the webinar today. You can see here, Insta360 Link. So as you can see by this, you know, diverse selection of cameras, we really cover a ton of different cameras, from action cameras here on the left. You can start with X3 to 1RS, and then to go to the world's smallest action camera on the right, which weighs 26 grams. And then on the right, we can see our prosumer and professional 360 cameras, our 360 1-inch edition there. We have the Pro 2 and we have the Titan, all the way up to professional grade Titan, which shoots 11K 360 VR. And it's used by Google to shoot Street View. So we really cover a big, wide selection of cameras there. And let's go back to the action cameras. We're redefining what's possible with action cameras with our selection there. We have our flagship X3 360 camera. We have the RS, which is a modular system, which I might talk a bit more about later, how you can literally change the modules, having the flexibility of having multiple cameras in one, being able to change around modules. Then go to the world's smallest action camera, 26 grams. It's incredible what you can do with that thing. And then, yeah, towards the right, professional grade cameras that can be used for cinematic VR productions. And then a three-axis 4K powered webcam, Insta360 Link, that I'm using today with AI gesture control, which is quite incredible. So, yeah, I think you get the picture. We cover a ton of different incredible cameras. So I just touched on this before, guys. A bit more company background. So over 900 employees, and you can see there on the map, our headquarters is in Shenzhen. And then we have the satellite offices in Los Angeles, Berlin, Hong Kong, and Tokyo. So an important thing to note is over 47% of our workforce is in R&D and engineering based in Shenzhen. And this allows us to really focus on the innovation needed to churn out constantly these incredible cameras. So with X3, that's our fifth product just of 2022 that we've released, and there's still more exciting products to come. So with all of this heavy focus in engineering and research and development, we are able to keep up with this innovation and keep churning out incredible, incredible technology with our incomparable hardware ecosystem and the global talent pool that we have. So as we mentioned there, a line I like, we can continue to innovate and inspire. Okay, so our media network for Insta360, you can see CNN, The Verge, Wired, Forbes, BBC. We've worked with them all into a truly global media network there. And our influencer network is also even more vast. So from some of the biggest influencers across the globe, from MKBHD, Unbox Therapy, Peter McKinnon, Matty Hapoya, iJustine, just to name a few, all covering our products and all have excellent resources online, by the way, if you want to check out their videos on our new products. These guys just released awesome X3 videos, which you can check out as well. Okay, so Insta360 X3 magic in action. I actually have one here with me that I'm going to be demonstrating and showing you guys today. And as you can note here, the box is actually signed by Bill Davidson. I've just got back from European Bike Week just a couple of days ago now. And I met Bill Davidson there and introduced him to X3. And he signed the box and he loves the camera too. So yeah, that's what I've been really excited about this week. So X3 magic in action. Let's kick on with some of the killer features. Right, excuse me, everybody. Okay, so X3 magic in action. So X3 is the ultimate 360 action camera for creators, adventurers, and athletes. So we'll be talking to you guys today a bit more about our different athletes, our different use cases, and what you can do with X3. So with X3, you can capture stunning and cinematic shots previously inaccessible, and you know, people would think, are you using cameramen, bulky drip gear, are you using drones, have you got pro editing skills? But now you can say, no, I've got my Insta360 X3. So let's talk through a few of the features here. Okay, while we're talking through the features, I'm gonna pull mine out of the box. So here we can see, guys, the Insta360 X3. So one of the most notable changes you'll see from One X2 is the 2.29 inch LCD tampered glass hard screen LCD screen on the front, which I absolutely love. It gives the camera a really solid feel, allows you to really easily navigate all of the menus. So that's a big difference with the camera. And then we can see on the top left, we're shooting in 5.7K 360 with active HDR. And the active HDR is super important. So now with that, you're able to pull even more details from the shadows and get a higher dynamic range from your videos. Then we go down 72 megapixel 360 photo. So I've been testing this out myself and the photo quality is incredible. I used to love pulling my 360 shots from my 360 videos, but now you can do it with the photo if you have a cool spot you're in and get even more quality. So again, I'll run through these quick because I'm going to go through them in a bit more detail soon, but the single lens, the 4K single lens mode is awesome. So for example, I really like mountain biking and a great POV shot is when I mount my X3 onto my chest like this. I love the 360 POV shots, but also now I've got the 4K single lens mode. We concentrate all the processing power of the camera into a single lens to give an even more incredible output, but you get a more kind of standard ultra wide angle action camera shot, which also looks fantastic with the camera. A few more killer features there. So we've got the bigger half inch 48 megapixel sensors. So again, bigger sensors, better low light performance, better dynamic range, and just all around more incredible shots with the camera. We've still got the same impossible third person views. I'll be talking to you guys through the selfie stick. I'll leave that till a bit later. We've got 60 frames per second Mi mode, and Mi mode's a brilliant one. So again, when it's on the invisible selfie stick, let me just get it on now. So when it's on the invisible selfie stick, as we see here, guys, in the past you would shoot, let me zoom out a bit. In the past you would shoot this and it would basically be the full 360. However, now with Mi mode, you're concentrating on the half of that sphere facing you. So again, concentrating more processing power towards you to deliver higher frames per second, better resolution, and a better shot when you just want to shoot yourself. So for example, here, when you're skiing there. And again, at the bottom, waterproof to 10 meters, which is great. You know, if you're doing water sports, if you're out, you know, getting wet, whether it's mountain biking, whether it's winter sports like skiing, you don't need to worry about any water there. And then also 8K 360 time-lapse video. This is a fantastic one. I would urge everyone to try out 8K. It looks absolutely stunning. And then the 4K 120 frames per second bullet time video. So this is where you have the special bullet time attachment. It can be on a stick like this, or it can be on a cord where you swing it around your head and then you get an awesome matrix style slow motion. So I actually have an athlete called Jeremy Tronney, who's a world famous kite surfer. And he actually just did one yesterday where he was on his surfboard. He managed to get on his surfboard and do a bullet time with X3, which looked amazing. Okay, next slide, guys. So one of the beauties of 360 and what's perfectly with X3 is the shoot first, point later. So with this, as I mentioned, I have it on my invisible selfie stick in this example. You should be able to see on the video. Let me just play it through again. So I have it on my invisible selfie stick here. So for example, I love skiing. I'm skiing along. I don't need to be thinking, all right, where is my camera pointing? Did I get the shot? Did I capture this moment? I'm shooting in 360. So I know that I'm capturing absolutely everything. So the beauty of this is it allows me to just enjoy and focus on the activity that I'm doing. And then I have the peace of mind knowing that no matter what happens, I've got everything. I've shot everything in 360. So I can then, after I've enjoyed my activity, I can check my video and reframe all the cool angles from that. Because the worst thing is, for example, another partner we work with, they're out doing whale watching and dolphin watching. And, you know, when a dolphin jumps up and surfaces next to the boat, they want to make sure they've got that shot. And if they're on a mobile phone or just on a standard wide-angle action camera, it's hard to know when an incredible moment like that pops up. So with a 360, you know, you've shot everything. And you don't need to be focusing on your angles and where the camera's pointing. So basically, yeah, we've got one shot, multiple perspectives equals ready-made B-roll. Right. And again, we've got flow state stabilization. So this is really a killer feature, guys. So again, if I mentioned there, I was just at European Bike Week last week, where I'm rigging up X3s onto Harley Davidsons. Guys are ripping around, even some of them going off roads where a lot of vibrations, a lot of bumps. But with flow state stabilization, it makes your video super smooth in the end. So you can see the difference here. I'll just run it through again. With no flow state stabilization and then flow state stabilization on, much smoother, cleaner video. And as I've kind of explained a little bit already, the invisible selfie stick, which is really such an awesome feature that still blows people's minds to this day. So with the camera having two lenses and each lens having around a 200 degree field of view, that combined with our technology and our app and the hardware in the camera makes the selfie stick invisible. And this also goes the same too. If you have a mount extension on a helmet, you have a mount extension on a motorbike, it's completely invisible. So you get this incredible, invisible drone-like shots. And like we mentioned earlier at the start, people are thinking, is there a cameraman? Is there a drone following there? And no, you're just using your camera with your invisible selfie stick. Like here, I've paused it. It's mounted from the handlebar sticking outwards. And then here, she's holding it in her hand in the helicopter. And then you can see here, he's got the invisible selfie stick mounted off the front. So as you can see the shadow there, guys, you can see it's mounted off the back of the motorcycle, and you can just about make out the shadow on the right of where the X3 is mounted. So invisible selfie stick is always, you know, a crowd pleaser, and I'd suggest testing it out with your X3. Okay, I've touched on this a little bit before. So the 4K single lens mode. So use X3 like a standard single lens camera. So as I mentioned, X3 is now a flagship 360 camera. You know, people absolutely love 360. I've already mentioned some of the things 360 cameras can do, but also people still love standard wide angle action camera shot, especially for POV like winter sports or mountain biking. So now you have the flexibility. You can shoot 360 shots, and you can also use it just like a standard wide angle action camera. And how we do that is now we put all of our power and processing behind one of the lenses, and you can choose actually which lens. And then we supercharge that lens to give awesome 4K ultra stable, ultra wide footage that's ready to share. So this is an awesome new feature for the camera too. Oh, sorry, let me just play the graphic here so you get a bit of a clearer idea. So here we can see the POV shots possible with the 4K single lens mode. Great. Okay, so let's keep going. So again, guys, we talk about having an AI video editor in your pocket. So I recommend everyone, even if you haven't got a camera, just download our app on our store and start having a check out of what's possible on there, and all the tutorials and our shot lab too. There's so much you can do on the app. And that's one thing we really focus so heavily on. As I mentioned before, 47% of our team are engineers involved in R&D. And a large amount of those resources are focused on our software, on our app, to make it as intuitive and as easy as possible to get all these incredible shots. So all you need to do is simply turn your camera on, make sure your Bluetooth and Wi-Fi isn't on your phone, and you can just connect your smartphone right to your camera. And then you can be editing footage directly from the camera. So you're not even having to download the footage onto your phone first, which could take a while. You can edit all the footage while it still lives on the camera, and then just pull and download an edit that you've made on your phone from the camera and only download that to your phone. So it saves a bunch of time, memory. And then, yeah, I'm going to be talking a bit more about our shot lab and what you can do literally just with your smartphone, our app, and the camera. So yeah, I'll be talking more about that soon. So here's just one of the features. So we have AI tracking features built into our app.
Can we go see a wave? Your mom has to get in with us. And then, what do you think of that?
It makes me so happy.
What do you think of that?
It makes you so happy.
So here, guys, what you can see is the AI tracking in our app using AutoFrame. It can identify with the AI the subjects in the video and focus on them. It can switch them up too. It's really got some incredible features. And I also love a similar feature called Deep Track, which again, so say I've shot a 360 video where I'm skiing down a mountain. I can literally just draw a square on my friend who's skiing along next to me. Maybe he's skiing to my left, to my right, behind me. And my 360 camera will keep my friend center focused the whole time. And there's tons of awesome use cases showing Deep Track. One of my favorites is with a mountain bike partner we have. She mounted the 360 camera on her dog. The dog was running alongside her as she's riding her bike down the track. And then as the dog's running around her, the dog's like her cameraman. And she used Deep Track to just focus herself as a subject in the middle. And then her dog's just running around her, but the whole time she's still centered focus. So that's just one possibility with AutoFrame. And again, let's move on now to cinematic shots without the equipment. Okay, so cinematic shots. So achieve cinematic shots without a camera crew, without expensive equipment like gimbals, camera rigs, drones, or dollies. All you need is your pocket-sized X3 action camera and a couple of accessories like the invisible selfie stick, and you're good to go. So here we sit. And then simply using our app, you can create all these incredible edits. So let me just show you this edit here by Karen X. Yeah, I know it, and I'm never looking back again. So again, guys, I'm not sure how it's looking over Zoom here. Might be a bit choppy with Zoom compressing it, but I would suggest checking out Karen's Instagram to see more of these amazing shots in their full glory and their full quality. But it's really incredible. You can see the comments here. People just mind blown about the cinematic edits possible with our cameras. And again, low budget. That's another thing we like to stress there. You know, you think about to do these edits professionally with camera crew, you know, professional tools, equipment, it's costing you thousands, but with an X3, you can easily just pull it out of your pocket, connect it to the app, and you know, you've got all these cinematic shots that are now possible. Right, so here's a funny one I'd like to talk more about. So Go Fish Vertigo Shot. So this one can be done with dangling your camera with a fishing rod on a fishing line, finding a really cool staircase, and then kind of unwinding the camera to go down. And then the rotations on the fishing line will then be removed by the camera due to its gyro data compensation. So basically what that means is although the camera might be spinning around a little bit as it's going down on the string, you don't need to worry because it's a 360 camera, that really doesn't matter and it doesn't impact your shot there. So here's an example of the shot. Here's the BPS. That's just one example there, guys. It's a 360 camera on a piece of string, and you can get an edit like that just by connecting it to our app. Here we go again. So Starlapse, this is again one of my favorite features. So you can just put your camera outside and shoot it overnight, then literally edit in minutes in the app rather than hours with professional and traditional cameras. Literally leave your camera out, use the Starlapse feature, and then edit it in minutes on the app to get an awesome effect like this. Excuse me there. Play that one more time. So there you go. Right. So moving on to impossible shots now with a 360 camera. So fake drone shots. I absolutely love this as well. So access narrow, expensive, or dangerous locations. And you can try with the extended 3-meter selfie stick. So I'd like to give you guys an example of this. When I just mentioned we've been at European Bike Week with our partner, Holly Davidson, We're at the event, we want to capture, you know, kind of drone shots. But the issue is now more and more drone legislation is coming up. You can't fly drones here, you can't fly drones there. So many rules. However, if you literally just have an extended selfie stick, or even with the 1m20 selfie stick, you can get some drone-like shots. Put your X3 on the top, extend it all the way out, put it up in the air, and you can literally be waving that thing around, getting insane drone-like shots. Okay, so I'm going to show you some examples here. One from Brandon Lee. You've got the extended 3-meter selfie stick there. Okay, and then here's one from Taylor Stevens. Awesome. I actually have a cycling partner in the UK, and he actually held the 3-meter selfie stick while he was riding his bike through the countryside. Admittedly, he was riding it slowly and there were no cars around. But really, with the selfie stick, you can get absolutely insane views. I also love using it when I go hiking in cool spots, because you can hang it over the edge of maybe you're climbing up a steep valley or you're on a mountain. It looks really incredible there. If you can lean your camera over the edge of a ravine or something, you know, keeping it safe, but you can get awesome shots that way too. Okay, so Tiny Planet. This is a tried and tested feature that's been a crowd pleaser for a long time now. And it's great for showing the relationship between subject and the environment. So I've got two examples below here I can show you guys. So you can shoot in 360 with the invisible selfie stick and then create a tiny planet feature, which basically puts all that 360 footage and bends it into one awesome effect like this. Wow. Okay, and the next one here. But yeah, just the thing to stress again, guys, is all these shots and effects are created with literally a pocket-sized action camera. Like, you look how small this thing is. I pop the lens cap on, I put that in my pocket. It's like a small smartphone size. And the versatility and the things you can do with this camera and our app are just absolutely nuts. And I know we've only got around 1 hour today to go through as much as I can, but you know, I could keep going for a whole day, but trying to pick out some highlights here to keep it concise and to share with you. Okay, so next slide here, we've got Time Shift. So this one, I love it absolutely too. So this is actually shot in Paris here. I'm going to show the example first before I give you the rundown. Right, so time shift here, the AI actually finds the highlights and it adds in dynamic speed ramping and 360 reframing. And then you can see here how it accelerates and slow the speed in a few taps. And you can also add motion blur for other effects. So again, time shift is another feature. And all you need to do here, you've got your Insta360 X3 on your invisible selfie stick. You just hit and record, you're walking along, you're enjoying your time. And then all you need to do is pull and drop that footage into our app. So you're not having to, you're still able to enjoy, relax, and you know, take your time while you're on your vacation or in a cool location. And then all of this editing and incredible post processing is done in the app after your activity. All right, okay. Get to the next slide. So Clone Trail. So this one is a really funny one and you know, gets great reactions online. So no more wasted hours masking and cloning your body in editing software. So to do without a 360 camera like X3, this takes an awful lot of expensive gear, expensive editing tools, and time. However, with this, you can just set the camera up on the invisible selfie stick, pop a little tripod on it, get it down, or you can even just stick it in the sand, maybe with your invisible selfie stick, and then just walk around the camera. Literally just walk around the camera and then go to Shot Lab in the app and outcome your clones in minutes. So this is really a funny one that blows a lot of minds online. Let me show you this one on the right here. And again, all done with X3, just literally connecting it to our app, which is also mentioned that app is free when you pick up the camera. And you've just got this AI powerhouse editing suite straight on your mobile phone, connect your camera, and all these shots are at your fingertips. Okay, so FollowCam. I actually mentioned this one a little bit before. So FollowCam on demand, shooting 360, and the app will reframe. AI can track people and animals. So we can see the shot on the left here. It's a Brazilian extreme sports athlete called Carol. I manage her, and she's actually in Los Angeles at the moment, and she went para hawking. So I'm going to show the video and then explain it a little bit more. Awesome. So basically what she's done here, she shot a video in 360. There's actually an extension coming off the left of the setup here, like an invisible selfie stick sticking out. And then from that 360 video, she can then pull up the app and literally use Deep Track to just draw a square. She's drawn a square on the subject, which in this case is the hawk. And then the AI tracking can keep the hawk center frame the entire shot. So I'm going to play it again so you can see she's drawn a square on that hawk. And because the 360 camera records everything, it then makes sure to keep the subject center frame. And we can see the one on the right here with the dog running around in the park. So this is just the owner here. They've got the selfie stick out in their hand and then just running along with the dog. You see the dog's changing position, it's running around. But again, just through using Deep Track and FollowCam, you draw a square on the subject and it's kept center frame the entire time. Bullet time. So as I was mentioning earlier, an example I absolutely loved was my athlete, a guy called Jeremy, who actually managed to do a bullet time whilst on a surfboard. That's the first one I've seen of those. But you can see it's automatic horizon leveling and has smart speed ramping. So it really gives you that kind of Matrix movie style shot where it's, you know, moving around the slow motion scene. I think I'm going to show you just some videos here so you can see it better. So you see that spinning the camera around like that, and you can see the angles and the shots possible. I'm going to share that one more time because it was quite quick. Literally spinning the camera around, you can have it on a stick, and you can also have it on a cord, which you can see on the left there. Then we've got another one here with Will Smith, who loves our cameras. And again, guys, you can shoot this in different locations and you can use the app to add in different transitions and just simply either using the bullet time cord accessory or the stick, which you saw, you can get these crazy, crazy shots. So see if you guys can think of any cool locations to try a bullet time where you are. And that's why I'm like... Right, next one, dolly zoom. Okay, so with dolly zoom, you can shoot in 360 with a selfie stick. You're holding the 360. You're holding the camera on the stick stretched outwards, and you can digitally zoom in on the app or use ready-made templates to get this effect. So I'm going to show you the video. Okay, so there you go. There's the dolly zoom effect. And traditionally, you would need a professional camera, even on a slider, to get an effect like that. Whereas I wish we had the BTS of this. And basically, it's just someone behind with the X3 on the selfie stick, running forward and running back, you know, trying to walk as smoothly as possible. And then again, connected to your app, and you've got this awesome effect. Stop motion. Okay, the next one. Eliminate hours of editing. That's another big one here. So not only do these shots cost a lot of money in equipment and gear if you're not using the X3, but also a lot of time, the editing that it would take to get this. But with X3, you can shoot in 360 for at least 2 minutes, and then the app will do the rest for you. And here's the effect produced. You get some funny shots like this with stop motion, right? Okay, so freeze frame. This is another brilliant one. So sometimes regular slow-mo just isn't slow enough. So now with your videos, you can have a 360 video and then have an epic freeze frame, slow-mo style right in the middle. There we go. Right, so there's the example jumping into the pool. And again, they're not having to worry because they know that X3 is waterproof to 10 meters, even without a dive case. And here we go, another one. So as you can see there, when the action peaks, you can use the freeze frame effect to get that awesome slow motion shot. So it adds a super dramatic effect to any footage. And again, just one tap in the app speed settings to access the freeze frame feature there. Right, so Sky Swap. This is an absolutely game-changing new feature we've included with X3 and added to our Shot Lab. So now you can actually literally use our AI editing suite on our app to change the sky in your videos. So I'm going to show an example here. So as you can see here, we've got surf borders, we've got sand borders, and you can literally change the sky to a ton of different things. So I'm gonna show you again. Now it's like underwater, now you've got a starry sky, now you've got like a painting underwater again, and it looks so seamless, and it almost looks real on some of them. You could really fool some people with this. I really like it as well. You can actually use Sky Swap to add in sunny skies if you're in an overcast place. So with me living in Germany, and with me being from the UK, this is a game changer because it's often quite cloudy and overcast there. So having the ability to literally swap the whole sky in my videos, add in a nice blue sky is fantastic, right? Nose mode. So this is a funny one. You can literally, so I'm not going to do it, but you can place your X3 camera literally in your mouth. So I open wide, put the camera in, just hold it in my mouth, and then as you can see the image here, you can check out more nose modes on our Insta360 Instagram page, guys. But yeah, you get these really funny videos where it's like this kind of warped big view of your face with the funny teeth, and they actually go super viral. There's tons going viral at the moment, so you've probably actually seen these before. So yeah, check some more out on our page for them. Right, so more creative templates in Shot Lab that you guys can check out. So let's just go through these ones quick. So we've got Street Labs. So you see again how you're shifting time and space, and look at all the awesome lights there. If you're in a place like this with fantastic lights, you can see how the long exposure and the Street Labs feature there produces an amazing result. So here we see Fly Lab. And guys, what I love as well so much about Fly Labs is you see all the movement there in the video. The person is not moving their camera around. They've just walking with the X3 on the selfie stick. extended up in the air over their shoulder. They're just walking along as normal, shooting a 360 video. Then they drop that 360 video into the shot lab using Flylabs, and then all the AI picks out awesome spots of interest and creates this movement and changes the speed. All done in the app. You don't even have to do anything to get that incredible edit. All you need to do, hit record, put your camera on your shoulder, then drop the footage into the app. So here we've got Jump Planet. So again, we talked a bit about the Tiny Planet feature before. So this is like in a video now, and you can shoot Jump Planet and change locations. Here we see on the right, we have Time Flip. And again, these are just a handful of the features in ShotLab, but you can really get the idea how just having this small pocket-sized X3 and the Insta360 app, the AI powerhouse editing suite, all the options that you have are crazy. Right. Okay, and next, guys, X3 as a VFX tool. Right, so being able to create raw content and then speed up post-editing with reframing. So again, you can see some of the comments there when people use X3 as a VFX tool. So let's check out a few of these edits. So you see a lot of music artists using X3 as a VFX tool to get crazy shots like this in their music videos. And here's one of my favorite editors, actually, Cash Bunny. She loves using X3. And here's one of her edits that she did. And you can see, although there's some extra tweaking involved to get these shots, X3 is the camera to shoot with. And then through having those raw files then and using our app and then using some extra software and tools, you can get shots like this, which absolutely blow minds, thinking that it's literally just a pocket-sized action camera. 'Cause I've been fed up before. Right, so I'd like to thank everyone for joining us today. And being able to let me run you through some of the main features for 360 reframing and creating awesome shots with your pocket-sized action camera. So I've kept a bit of time here now for some questions. So I think if Derek, you'd like to join in.
Yeah, definitely.
We can run through to see.
Definitely. Adam, thank you so much for that. I swear, it blows my mind still, even watching it again. And I have a good friend of mine I was telling you that I've run with who takes videos using a 360 camera. And I can personally vouch for it that the in-app software is amazing. I've tried to show him like Premiere and he's like, nope. He's like, what I do in here? He's like, I can do it right from my phone, right there at the time of. He's like, it gives me options. You can do stuff on there that it would take you days and weeks to even learn to do in like processing software.
Absolutely, Derek. And I've got people regularly, they see these 360 videos and they're like, oh, I could never do that. And they seem to think that they need like a university degree in editing just to be able to make these edits. And it's like, no, I'm showing them. I'm like, look, here's my app on my phone. Here's my camera. Here's the video I took, bang, in ShotLab. 30 seconds later, I've got edits like this that I can just then share easily.
Yeah, and I think that's like one of the cool things, because most people feel like, are coming from the industry, when you look at it from like an industry perspective, it's like, no, if you don't do it, you know, if you don't upload your clips into video editing software and do it all yourself, then it's you know, you're not going to get a good result. I think we kind of have like this idea of like phone apps being like, okay, well, you can do like general corrections, but nothing really crazy. And he's doing wild stuff that's feeding into what the camera is capturing. And the videos look sick. I mean, the footage is sick. The editing and the way that the cuts are and the fact that the AI is taking care of the lion's share of all of that.
Yeah, absolutely. It's pretty mind-blowing what these cameras can do. And before I forget, I just wanted to mention to all the viewers today, make sure to check us out on our Instagram. So I've just basically shown you a tiny little snippet of what these cameras can do today. Derek's only let me have 1 hour. I could be going on for days about all these edits and things the cameras can do and showing you all the cool footage. So I'd really recommend everyone to check us out on Instagram, on our YouTube. See, just Insta360. And then you'll be able to just feast your eyes on all the other cool content and check out maybe your sports in particular and how the X3 can be used for that.
Definitely. And if Adam's up to it, well, you know, we got to get you back, man. Like you said, there's so much more to dive into. And I feel like you really just scratched the surface here and you had to rush it to get it all into an hour.
Yeah. Get me back.
Definitely. And now I know there's a lot to dive into. We do have a question that came in from online asking about the customization. How much customization is there available with the products? Are you able to mod them or switch things from different products or add to?
Sorry about that, Derek. I seem to have lost you for a second there. Can you still hear me okay?
Yes. Yep, we got you.
Brilliant. Could you repeat that last part, please?
Yes. So we had a question about the customization of the products. How much can you mod them? How much can you customize them?
Okay, so in terms of customization of the products, if you have a ton of different accessories, you know, as long as there's a 1/4-20-inch mount here, you can screw in all your different kinds of accessories and use them however you like.
I think you froze on us there, Adam. Put this down.
Sorry about that, Derek.
No worries. Yeah,
I think you're having a little technical.
At least it waited, right? It waited until you got through the bulk of the presentation.
Am I still here?
You're still here. We have you in and out. And I will say, for those of you that are joining us, we're just trying to get, Adam just had a little bit of a snag there with the tech. So we're just working on getting that handled here. All right, so we have Adam frozen here, and we're going to try to get him back there. We're going to give it a minute. I know we do have some questions coming in. It looks like we'll see if we can get Adam to rejoin in here. It looks like Adam's going to try to jump out and jump back in. While we're waiting for Adam to come back in, I do want to remind everybody that we do broadcast Monday through Thursday. So you can get anywhere from 1 to 3 workshops a day. Tomorrow, we're going to be jumping into Lightroom Classic with Tim Gray. Those of you who do watch should know Tim Gray by now. We have him on fairly regularly. Knows his way around Lightroom. We're going to be talking about that. And then we have nothing until next Tuesday, September 20th. Where David Molnar is going to be taking us through his new book, Learning to See. Of course, all of our content is archived online. So if you have not checked us out on Facebook, do so at BH Event Space. And on vimeo.com/BH Event Space, we are also, of course, on Instagram at BH Event Space. So you can check on our upcoming content on there as well. We're going to see if Adam's able to jump back in. I wish I had. There we go. We got him up there. I think we're getting.
Hello. Can you hear me now?
There you go. I was gonna say. I'm like, normally I can hold up and say, you know, I can fill the gap, but I don't know these products like you do.
Yeah. My apologies there. At least my internet dived right at the end of the
exactly.
Webinar, which I'm grateful for. But yeah, I'm just back if I still have time to answer any more questions.
Yes, definitely. Definitely. So we did have a question from Ronnie joining us here on Zoom. Says, I've had the Insta360 ONE X2 for a few years, taken it to Africa, Italy, and just returned from East Cuba. I love the 360. The software for my computer is much better than it used to be. Makes me want to upgrade to the 360 X3. So Ronnie says, going to Iceland soon. Of course, we'll take the 360 as well. The X3, what are we people looking at upgrade-wise if somebody's coming from an X2?
Yeah, so some of the main upgrades from your X2 is, first of all, the 2.29-inch LCD touchscreen there, which makes it a lot more user-friendly if you want to just hold it like a smartphone. I really like and navigating the menus like this. We've got the larger half-inch image sensors, which really bring out more quality, high dynamic range, better low light performance. So I think, for example, in somewhere like Iceland, and as well, I mentioned the 8K time-lapse feature. That's really a killer shot. And if you're trying to shoot like northern lights or cool spots while you're in Iceland, I would suggest, yeah, having that 8K time-lapse option for the X3 is going to be really big.
Awesome. Well, Adam, that looks like we've wrapped up the questions. This is super cool stuff. Again, we're going to have to get you back. We got to take a little bit of a deeper dive, maybe dive into some of the products more in depth and see what we can do. And we got to get you over here to New York. That's what we really need. We need to do a live demo. I got to get you out on the streets in New York with one of these things and see what we could do.
That would be fantastic. That would be brilliant.
That'd be awesome, man. Well, Adam, I want to send a huge thank you to you, of course, the whole Insta360 team for making this happen, introducing these wonderful products to us and to all of our viewers, of course, for joining in. And one more time, Adam, if you could just drop the Instagram where people can check out more of the content.
Yeah, absolutely. So guys, pull up Instagram and just search Insta360, INSTA360. You can see that also on the website, and just put that in and you'll see us there. We've got over 1.2 million subscribers and growing quickly on our Instagram. And also same on YouTube. YouTube's an awesome spot for us. You can see all of our full length videos on there. We've got a Think Bold video series as well, as I mentioned with some of those guys, Hunter Kowald, Evan Lalane, recently with Jetson, the flying car company. So there's so much out there. And again, I wanted to mention too, so I mentioned earlier our network of influencers globally. So we've got, you know, mountain bikers, kite surfers, video creatives, you know, like Karen X, like I showed, basically all across the board, tech reviewers. We've got everyone. So no matter what your hobbies are, what your interests are, there's a huge amount of resources online, you know, giving you constant new tutorials and everything you can do. And then you also have our app with all, you know, tutorials on as well. So when you get the camera, you have a wealth of resources out there for more inspiration and tips, which I think is super helpful.
Oh, definitely. And I think that is a great point, you know, to get in there, is that I think when we think about cameras like this, we think only action sports. And you really can do anything. And I think it's what your presentation showed, is that there's way more options than just hanging off the side of a mountain or going skateboarding down a hill. There's so many things you could do, even for people who aren't athletes at all. I think you can find creative ways to do this. There's so much content creation out there and people trying to reach into the next realm of like creativity. What can I do that's different than somebody else? And
exactly. And like I said, Derek, I only really put a dint in the possibilities. And yeah, maybe if you're not into action sports, you could use this camera on your selfie stick and take incredible virtual tours of your house or properties. There's a whole enterprise use case out there as well. Like, and I'm trying to control myself because I can just keep going on and on and on and on about everything you can do with this camera. But yeah, I'd really urge everyone, just check out our Instagram and have a scroll down and just look at all the different ways that this thing can be used.
Maybe I'm just going to get a 360 and start streaming from the event space from it and annoy everybody constantly with some content.
That's what, yeah, do it.
We'll go full chaos mode.
But awesome.
Adam, thank you so much again. Again, a huge thank you to all of the Insta360 team. But that's it. That's all we got for you today. We will be back tomorrow, as I had stated. And that's it. Another rendition of B&H Virtual Event Space is in the books. Catch you all next time.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Adam.